Are you looking to make your website load less than 1 second, but you just can't achieve it? You've tried cache plugins, CDN, and it's still not loading less than 1 second? Well, there's a piece that's missing to your puzzle, and it's called WP Shifty. It does exactly that. It helps you with that third piece missing from your puzzle. It removes files that are loading that are unnecessary for certain pages. It's great because it's super easy to use and it visually loads when you make those changes, so you don't have to make changes when it goes live. Now, I know it's not super cheap, but it's well worth it if speed is crucial for you. I've tried looking for free plugins, different type of plugins that are alternative that are cheaper, but I mean, they just don't cut it out. It's hard to use, they are clunky, and it's just not as good as WP Shifty. So do check it out. That link will be in the description. Now, what does WP Shifty do? Like I mentioned before, it removes file loads. Now let's just say that you have a home page and you're not using your contact plugin, you're not using, I don't know, some X plugin, right? Well, you can remove from those plugins loading on certain pages, post pages, home page, contact page, and you reduce the load by removing those files. Like I mentioned before, super easy to use. Let me show you what I'm talking about on my desktop right now. All right, this is my site already with WP Shifty, and before I actually show you how it looks, let me show you my GT metrics for my site. This is saasmaster.net, and you can head on over there and make your own test. Do be aware, I'm always testing my site, so changes do happen, all right? So in this case, my site loaded in 597 milliseconds, all right? So that's almost half a second to load my site. That's super fast, all right? So that's the speed that I'm getting with the combination of cache plugin, CDN, and WP Shifty. Now, I know you're gonna say, you know what, my cache plugin does remove unnecessary CSS files. You know what happens? I already tried it. I have WP Rocket and I'm paying for it month to month, well, yearly. And it does have that feature, remove unnecessary CSS files. But what does it do? It breaks my site. And it doesn't have settings to, hey, don't remove this and keep this. And that's why I'm using WP Shifty and I'm getting these speed loads. Now on page speed for Google, this is what I'm getting for desktop, which is 97% performance. And on mobile, I'm getting 76%. I'm still working on that one because it's way hard. Trust me, 76% on mobile with Google page speed is actually pretty good, all right? So those are my performance for that site. I also have other sites where I'm using it. And yes, it's loading less than 1 second. Now, how hard is it to use? Okay, so all you have to do is add a new scenario, and I'll do that right now because I don't want to mess with the ones I'm already using. And this is how it's going to load. This is what I like about WP Shifty and others don't have. It's visual. I mean, you can look at things. So I'm going to start off by clicking on the plus, and it's going to ask me, where do I want to make these changes? So I can work on a specific page. So for example, if I work on the contact page, man, I don't need to load practically anything. It's a clean site. All I need is my page builder, my SEO, and my form builder. That's all. And for example, I can choose post type. So I remove things on post, author, search, admin pages, Ajax, front page. I'm going to work with that one right now. I'm going to save it. And this is going to remove for front page. Now, I'm not going to save it because I already have a front page built. So it's gonna load my site, and this is what it's going to look like. And basically it loaded my settings from my other one, but that's okay. You can see all the things that I removed on my homepage. So I removed these plugins from loading on this site. Now, heads up, they might be loading or not, but I'm just removing them just in case they are. So all I need on this site is Elementor, WP Bakery, Media Ace, my security plugin, my compression, my cache plugin, and my SEO. That's all. I don't need to load my backup plugin, my automatic plugin, WordPress popular post, WhatsApp reaction, snacks, photo mix, my fluid forms plugin. All of that doesn't have to be loaded on my site. And it's removing those files from actually even loading on my site. And that reduces my server load and it increases my speed efficiency. So that's pretty cool. And now, apart from removing plugins from actually loading, we can view everything live right here. So if I turn off something, for example, WP Bakery, which is my builder that I'm using for this site, well, guess what? My header just went away. Let's wait for it to load. And I'm visually looking at what happened. So hey, It's telling you WP Shifty, hey, don't remove it because, well, that's going to happen. So I gotta bring it back up. Hey, where is it? Here it is, okay? So I can visually see what's going on when I remove it. That's what's so cool about WP Shifty. That's what makes it easy to use. Now I can also remove CSS files from the plugins that I left active, and I can go in depth into these. So for example, WP Bakery Page Builder, I can disable certain functions that load with that. Media Ace, well, there's these two files. Hey, maybe I only need one of those files from Media Ace and not both of them. So that's gonna, it's gonna work with you, and you gotta disable and enable things that you need or might need. Plus, you can do some testing to make sure that you actually don't need that file. Member and unknown files, all of these files are loading, and I can see what I want and don't want depending on my needs. Is it gonna break my site or not? The JS, again, the JavaScript files, so I can remove those also from these plugins because maybe I don't need them. So for example, there's these right there, WP Bakery, there's the Bimber ones, there's the core files that I might not need, some I do, some I don't, and I just need to play around with these to make my site load even faster, all right? So that's how easy it actually is. Now, right now, it's working on my homepage, so that's the front page. I can add more pages to this specific automation where it's removing those plugins. But heads up, my tests are done on this page and I only want it specifically for this one. Now, I will make a second one for the contact page where I will even need less of these files loading because I don't need media aids, I don't need other files, and it won't load those on those pages. There's also the editor for this, which is a little bit more complex. If you know coding, that you might want to start off here, which makes it even more fine-tuned to this plugin. You can add new rules, you can inject, you can preload and load behavior with this. I can go ahead and save it and activate it. I'm not going to do it because I don't want to mess with the homepage, but I can add more to this specific automation that I did where it's removing those files. So for example, depending on the device, well, I can load or not load certain files to make, for example, on certain devices, on mobile devices, even less light. So it's gonna make it load even faster. And that's something that I need to work with to get my page speed up from Google. So I need to remove some files for the mobile phone so it loads faster. And that is possible with this plugin. Now, like I mentioned before, this is kind of possible with other plugins, but it's complex, it's clunky, and it's ugly. I mean, you don't get these settings, you don't get a visual view of what's going on. And what's going to happen? Well, you're going to disable some of these plugins on other type of plugins for this, and you're gonna have to save it and then go check your site because you need to go load it, and it just makes things load, I don't know, it's just more hassle, and it's not so visually easy as this. That's what makes it really good for me. I know that I can install on several sites and just do my test really quickly and get it over with. Now, like I mentioned before, you can add more pages to this if you like. So for example, if I wanted to get this flow on another page, here we go, I can add these pages, for example, activity, ad blocker, acceptable policy, blah, 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 and I can save it and it'll add those same rules for those pages. Now I'm going to get out of here because I don't want to do any more mess. Okay, let me go back here. Now, this is a condition I just created. I didn't save it, I'll just delete it. And you can see I've applied it on my front page and on my contact page. I'm still working on this one, but you can see I have 10 plugins disabled for the contact and 11 plugins, one CSS and one script disabled for the front page. That's what's helping me, that missing puzzle to get that page speed. Because I have a cache plugin, I'm using Bunny CDN also, but I still wasn't getting these speed loads. I mean, talk about fast, right? Less than 600 milliseconds. Now, upon my different type of test, I've been getting from 500 to 800 milliseconds. So under a second with that combination of cache plugin with WP Rocket, you can use any cache plugin that you want. I'm using Bunny CDN. If you guys want to check that out, I made a video on it, which is, I'll leave the link in the description, and WP Shifty, which helped me accomplish that little piece of the puzzle to load my site faster. And again, I'll leave that link in the description. And in case I can find a deal for you guys where there's a coupon or something, I'll leave it also here in the description. Well worth the money that you're paying for this. I know it's yearly and I know it's not so cheap, but if page speed is crucial for you and you want to get that SEO ranking, well, this could be the plugin that's missing in your arsenal. Well, that is WP Shifty. I thank y'all for watching. My name's George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.